Hey guys, it's Peter here. In this video, I'll be solving the number 9 most popular kata or code challenge on Code Wars. The problem is called disinvalid trolls, and it's asking us to write a function that takes a string and return a new string with all vowels removed. Okay, so the main idea of this challenge is pretty straightforward. We want to build a new copy of the string, but without any of the vowels in the string. The best way to form a new string in Python is simply to create a new list of characters and then join the characters together at the end. The reason we do this roundabout way to create a string is because a normal string concatenation can be very inefficient. Every single time we concatenate, Python will need to create a new string from scratch. Alright, so let's first define what the vowel characters are. This includes lowercase and uppercase a, e, I, o, u. We can then initialize our new list of characters. Now to filter out the vowels from the input string, we need to loop through each character and append a character to the new list only if it is not a vowel. And finally, our new string can be built and returned by joining each of the characters in the list together. Okay, perfect. Actually, for this problem, we can turn our previous solution into a one-line solution. There are two main ways to do this. The first way is to use the built-in filter method that is also common in other programming languages. For the first parameter, we need to pass in the function that returns true or false. For simple filter logic like this one, we will generally use a lambda function. These are also widely referred to as anonymous functions. The second parameter is, of course, the sequence we want to filter on, which in this case is our input string. So we want to filter out and use each character in our string that is not a vowel. Great, and that's it. The second way to solve this problem in one line is to be more Pythonic and use a generator expression. The generator expression will perform essentially the same operation as the filter function we just used. So for character and string, we want to append the character if character is not a vowel. And that's it. Once you get used to seeing generator expressions or list comprehensions, they become much easier to understand and use. They can help make your code more concise and readable at a glance. Just be careful not to overdo it. For instance, I would not recommend converting nested for loops into list comprehensions, as they can actually make the code harder to read. Alright, and that's it. I hope these solutions helped you understand this problem a bit more. If you have any questions about this problem or about Python, please feel free to ask them in the comments section below. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next coding video. Thanks!